Welcome to Turbo Tips, where we get the top tips on a trending topic from YouTube's hottest creative talent. I'm Jen McKinnon, and in this episode, we hear from Nemanja Sekulic, Imad Awan, Benny Van Valen from Benny Productions, and Unmesh Dinda from PiXimperfect for their tips on compositing images in Photoshop. This video is brought to you by Envato Elements, a subscription-based library full of digital assets to help you get your creative projects done. Check the description below for a special offer from the Envato team. First up, we have Nemanja Sekulic of nemanjasekulic.com. Nemanja started his creative journey 20 years ago. He's a photographer, digital artist, educator, and BenQ ambassador. Famous for his quirky photo manipulations, his work has amassed an audience from all over the world, and his how-to videos have brought in over 16 million views on YouTube. Over to you, Nemanja.
Hey guys, it's Nemanja, and welcome to my number one photo manipulation tip. In order to create realistic composite, all the elements that you're using for that needs to match in perspective, lights, and colors. By perspective, I mean that all the elements need to be taken from the same angle, same distance, with the same focal length, so basically same lens. So if you're taking photo of a background, some street, for example, and you want to take that photo from really low angle, almost ground level, with a wide angle lens, and then you want to put a model on that background, and you're taking a photo of a model with maybe telephoto lens with more high above angle, those two photos will never match realistically. So to have a realistic result, you need to take a photo of a model from the same angle, ground level, with the same wide angle lens. Then lights. All the elements need to have same lighting conditions. So for example, if the background has a key light from left side, then the model needs to be lit to have a key light from the same left side. Or if the background has some kind of a complex light setup, then you need to take a photo of a model with the same, or at least as close as the same light setup as the background was, or to paint some light later in Photoshop. And third, colors. All the colors needs to be matched together, so you need to color correct every single element to make the impression that everything belongs to the same color palette. Right guys, that's it for today. Have fun, experiment, and see you next time. Bye bye.
Each of our experts have put together a themed composite kit full of items you can use to create your own composite images. Nemanja's put together a quirky composite kit to challenge you, so check that out in the description below. Next, we'll jump into the finer details with Unmesh Dinda from PiXimperfect. He'll show us how to apply realistic shadows to our compositions. Unmesh is the founder of the PiXimperfect brand, which primarily delivers free tutorial content on YouTube, but you can also subscribe for exclusive content on the PiXimperfect Patreon page. With tutorials on almost every Photoshop topic, he's one of the biggest names in Photoshop editing, so much so that he's even speaking at the upcoming Adobe Max conference, which makes him more than qualified to bring us our next tip. The floor is yours, Unmesh.
Hey there, my friend. Whenever you're creating a composite, you don't have to work too hard to create the most realistic shadow. If your subject already has a shadow that is clean enough, all we gotta do is to extract it. And we can easily do that with four simple steps. So let's get into it. Step number one, place the subject over the new background. So here we have a new background wall. So I'm just gonna drag and drop this photo over the canvas here in Photoshop. Step number two, select the subject and the shadow separately. With the subject layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J. Let one be the subject and let the other be the shadow. Now turn off both the shadow and the background and select the subject layer, and using your favorite method, make a selection. I'm just gonna use Select Subject. So with the active selection, click on the mask button. Now we're gonna turn on the shadow layer. Select the lasso tool. You don't have to be very accurate, leaving a little space. Just select the shadow area. Select the shadow layer and then click on the mask button. Let's turn on the background. Now I feel like in the original photo, light is coming from the left hand side, but with the subject, light is coming from the right hand side. So you can invert any one of those. But since in the background we already have text, let's just select the shadow layer, hold the Ctrl or Command, select the subject layer, press Ctrl or Command T, right click on it and choose Flip Horizontal. That way it's flipped, now you can center it accordingly. Now the shadow is definitely not looking realistic, so step number three is adjusting the shadow. Now what does the shadow do? it darkens stuff. Now, what is the blend mode which darkens? Multiply. So select the shadow layer, change the blend mode from normal to multiply, and it already looks amazing. Now, sometimes it might include a little bit of other areas. So how do we control that? With curves. So click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves. Make the highlights a little bit brighter, make the shadows darker, but it's affecting everything. We only want it to affect the shadows. So click on this button, it creates a clipping mask. So it will only be limited to the shadow layer. Now, if the shadow also brings along with it some additional color, create a hue saturation adjustment layer. Also, click on this button to limit it to the shadow layer, and then you can control the saturation if you wish to. So step number four is simply color matching. Here you can use curves, blend modes, whatever techniques you desire to match the color of the subject with that of the background. In this case, the color cast on the subject is not according to the new background, as you can see right here. So to fix that, make a copy of the background and then place it at the very top above the subject. Hold the Alt key or the Option key and click on the line between these two layers to limit it just to the subject, then blur it. Go to Filter, Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. Choose a very high value, something around 300, and hit OK. Now change the blend mode from normal to, guess what? Color, because we want to improve the color. Now we don't want to apply it throughout and make him a joker. So hold the Alt key or the Option key and click on the mask button to create a negative mask. Now take the brush, white as the foreground color, and just paint over the areas where you want to correct the colors. You can also decrease the flow of the brush if you want and continue just creating those color casts. See, now it's looking better. Now, of course, this is too much, so decrease the opacity. Now you can take all the time in the world to add color lookup tables on top of this, add more curves, do more blending and matching, polish the mask, make it cleaner. The possibilities are limitless. But that's how you can extract very realistic shadows by using real shadows.
Unmesh's artistic composite kit is available via the link in the description, so check that out and see what you can come up with the assets inside. With our shadows looking fresh, next up we have Benny Van Valen from Benny Productions to help us get our highlights right. A true creative in every sense of the word, Benny is only 18 years old and has risen to YouTube fame through his incredible talent, high-level engagement with his online community, and passion for digital art. His YouTube channel, Benny Productions, focuses on the entertainment value of photo manipulation rather than pure education, which has made him one of the fastest growing Photoshop channels in the world. Take it away, Benny.
Hey guys, my name is Benjamin, also known as Benny from my YouTube channel Benny Productions, and today I'm showing you my favorite Photoshop compositing trick in 2 minutes, making highlights. Now imagine you have a subject and an explosion, or a soldier and a very bright colored sky, or a cute little demon with a huge volcano behind him. You will need highlights. First of all, you should make a new hue and saturation adjustment layer. Check the little checkbox colorize and try to match the color with your light source. Then increase the luminosity a lot, because well, this is light. Once you have the right color, make sure to put it in a clipping mask with the subject by clicking in between the two layers while holding Alt. Then invert the layer mask with Ctrl or Command I, which is the default hotkey for inverting stuff. Now all you gotta do is take a little soft brush and start painting your highlights. Make sure your mask is selected though, not the layer itself. You can use X to switch between show and hide. White shows and black hides. Once you have some highlights you're happy with, sometimes it may help to add a little blend if. That you can access by double clicking on your highlights layer and dragging the lower slider you see here to the right. That however may look weird, so in order to fix that, try holding Alt while clicking on the slider. This splits it into two parts, which gives you a smoother result. Now that's how you can paint some awesome highlights. Of course the color and visibility varies depending on your artwork, but usually if you have the right color, this works. This technique I've been using in my artwork for quite a while now, and I personally think it brings the whole thing to life. I hope this was useful to you. If so, share this with your fellow Photoshop friends. And then I hope I'll see you around sometime.
Benny's post-apocalyptic composite kit includes items used in some of his top performing videos, so check that out in the description below. Finally, we have Imad Awan to show us a little trick with blending modes to allow us to quickly and seamlessly merge images. Imad is the creator of jaw-dropping concept art pieces celebrating characters from The Witcher, The Joker, and was even commissioned to work on the Lord of the Rings card game. His work has hit the spotlight on his YouTube channel, and you can also find his portfolio on his website, imadawan.com. Let's get blending.
Hey guys, how's it going? Hope you're having a great day. My name is Imad Awan. I'm a concept artist and illustrator working in the video game industry. Now, I don't usually do very clean looking photo manipulations, but I do use photo bashing techniques to create incredible concept art pieces. In today's video, I'm gonna be talking about a really cool tip that can help you merge two images together in an abstract manner. It works wonders. So without wasting any more time, let's do this. So I have this amazing photograph of a rocky landscape. I really love the colors and the overall look and feel of it. So I imagined, what if these are some ruins instead of just rocks? Or maybe the ruins are of a city carved inside these rocks. Even better, right? Absolutely. That's exactly what we are gonna do. So I'm using another image here. I'll make a selection around that building. Look at those old pillars and brick walls. Exactly what we need here. Once selected, I'll put it over that base image, which is this rocky landscape. Now let's do some magic. I'll right click on the ruins layer and then go to blending options. You'll see these sliders at the bottom. This, my friends, is our magic wand right here. When I move the darker side of that slider, look what happens. The darks from the photograph begin to fade and the underlying layer shows through. And if I move the lighter side of the slider, the light areas of the photograph fades. And again, the rocks and the background layer are visible and merged nicely. Isn't that great? This has really helped me with my concept art ideation process and for quickly merging two images to get abstract results fast and easy. You can of course tweak and experiment with these sliders to get the desired results. Oh, and you can turn the opacity down to help it fit better with the atmospheric perspective of that base image. Because when the things are at a distance, the darks do not seem very dark. I'm now experimenting with other photographs as well, making selections around different structures, merging them with the rocks using the same blending technique, and moving the sliders until it looks good. And I'm matching the colors using the great match color feature in Photoshop. Let's do one more, because this structure really matches with our taller rock formation in the background. Now again, match the colors of the two images, right click on the layer and go to blending options, play with the sliders and merge it with the background. Later on, you can also darken the edges of the artwork, add a vignette effect, refine the shapes and the edges a bit more, paint some nice fog at some places, add a bit of separation around the midground and the background structures, maybe add some distant mountains, and oh yes, a foreground element. If your foreground elements are darker in value and your background elements are lighter in value, this will create an illusion of depth, which looks great. Oh, and one last thing, don't forget to add a little concept art dude in your artwork. It will really help you sell the scale of the environment. Alright, hope you guys enjoyed this. Have fun creating. See you again.
Imad's put together a fantasy composite kit to get your creative juices flowing, so check that out via the link below. It's time to get compositing. If you're already an Envato Elements subscriber, pick your favorite kit from the links in the description below. Create your masterpiece using the items inside, and be sure to upload your finished product to social media with the hashtag MadeWithEnvato for your chance to be featured on our social pages. Don't have an Envato Elements subscription? With a special offer from the Envato team in the description below, now's the perfect time to sign up. You can't go wrong with over a million digital creative assets to choose from and unlimited downloads across all categories, from stock images and graphics to templates, textures, brushes, presets, actions, fonts, and more. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel so we know to produce more content like this. And let us know which creative topic you want us to cover and the YouTubers you'd like to see featured. Finally, make sure you check out our Tipmasters channels via the links in the description. Catch you next time!